The classes taught in high school are meant to prepare students for life beyond, for being a critically thinking citizen, for college, for careers, for managing personal finances and life's challenges. But many of the most important lessons students learn are taught through activities and clubs. The importance of caring for others, the value of teamwork, and the necessity of perseverance. In this episode of Senior Spotlight, we travel to Roosevelt High School, where one student is leading by lifting others up. If you're a high school senior with homework, college, work responsibilities, and social commitments on your mind, perhaps this is the ideal way to spend an afternoon after school, on the links with friends. But this isn't leisure, this is practice. There's a tournament tomorrow, and these student athletes are deep in preparation.
I don't think most people recognize what a mental sport golf can be. You can teach anyone the swing and how to be good as far as the athletic ability goes, but the mental portion is something that a lot of people don't recognize. And so just working on how to be tough and how to accept when things don't go your way and how to push through that is something that we really try and work on.
Helping lead this team is senior Max Erickson.
We're lucky this year we have great senior leadership, and Max is one of them. And just to kind of show our younger players how, whether you're playing good or you're playing bad, you can still represent your school and your team well. That representing yourself and your school and your team doesn't have to do with how you play golf, but how you act when you're in the community and even when people aren't watching. Max is a great leader. He's really good at lifting people up. He's probably one of the best examples that we have of not letting a bad round get to you and supporting your teammates even if your personal day doesn't go the best, you know. In golf, a lot of times we think of it as an individual sport, and high school is really the chance where they get to be individuals and part of a team. So being able to say, okay, personally I didn't do well today, but I can still be a supportive member of my team is really important, and Max does a great job of that.
Usually summer, we usually play all these bunch of summer tournaments, for like SDGA tournaments we call them, or SDJC. We play a bunch of those to get ready for all these school tournaments around the state. Then we, as a team, normally just come out and play practice rounds and stuff like that. And then once the season comes, we prepare for state practice, going greens, putt, chip, whatever, just to kind of keep our games in the flow so we're playing well by the state tournament. Me as a person, I'm not doing that well, but as a team, we're doing really well. So hopefully we can make a run at state this year. OG should be a tough competition, but I think we can do it if we all keep on working together and just play as a team.
So Max doesn't think he's doing the best personally. Does his coach agree?
Everyone goes up and down in their rounds. I mean, you have a good one, you have a bad one. And so the key is, like I said, perseverance and grit, which is something that we're trying to teach, that things, again, don't always go your way, but you just push through it and eventually hard work pays off.
It's a relatively short season for these high school students, but it requires year-round effort.
Our golf season is really only 2 months out of the year, but most of these players compete year-round. So what we do as a team is that we do fundraisers that are team builders as well to kind of be out and helping in the community. Also, we are at Golf Addiction all winter to continue to practice, and then that's good team building as well. We have fun competitions and such, but just to keep swinging throughout the winter. And then when it comes to the spring and summer months, the boys are competing in state competitions, which is great, which I'm not so much a part of, but I'm constantly looking at their scores and watching how they're doing.
And midway through the season, that hard work is showing results.
I'd say we're about midway through, maybe a little under midway through the season. We have Mitchell coming up, then we have two more rounds of city, and then we have Metro, and then the city tournament, or the state tournament right after that. Yeah, there's a lot of, there's two freshmen and one sophomore. The sophomore is number one on our team. He's been doing really well. I think he won the last tournament in a playoff. But the rest of my team has been shooting really well. Like, I was doing as good as them in the summer, but they've just continued to keep on doing well while I'm going down. But if we're doing good as a team, then I mean, I couldn't be really happier.
We have our second round of city tomorrow, and so there's three rounds of the city tournament leading up to the Metro tournament, which is kind of a precursor to state. And we'll go to state October 2nd and 3rd. So the first week of the Roosevelt homecoming, we will be participating in state. So kind of a fun way to ring in the homecoming for our seniors. Our goal is to be top three this year, but always you want to come in first. So we're pushing towards that. But again, just keeping in mind that it's a marathon, not a sprint, and that we're going to keep working hard until we get there, and hopefully things will go our way.
There's a slight twist to this story, namely that Max had never touched a golf club until his freshman year of high school.
I used to play baseball, and then I didn't want to put all my summer towards baseball, so I switched over to golf. And I don't know, there's something about golf where you don't always like get what you want, so you always want to come back for more. And like if you don't get a shoot a certain score, then you always want to keep on coming back for more. So here I am, I'm in my senior year. So.
And he's not the only one.
No one in my family really plays golf, so I just kind of took it up by myself and started playing. Me and my friends do, so we always play baseball, and now we're all playing golf, so it's kind of a weird transition, but so here I am.
And I don't know how that happened. Baseball's loss, I guess. I'm happy to take them. A lot of them have told me that the baseball swing and the golf swing, while similar, can mess each other up, so I know that they didn't want to keep doing both because they kind of interfere. So golf won out, I guess. Actually, all four of our seniors didn't start until they were freshmen in high school, which is amazing. And I think that just speaks to the amount of work that they've put in to excelling at their craft. The fact that they've been able to accelerate this game that usually takes 10 to 15 years to master, and they're state contenders in 4 years, I think really speaks to their hard work and dedication.
As a senior, Max is looking forward to the future.
I'm thinking if I get a scholarship for golf that I would continue to play, because I love playing it. It's a lot of fun. But I'm not for sure yet. We'll have to see how the season ends up. Right now I'm thinking SDSU for wildlife management or something with wildlife, because I really enjoy that. Yeah, I hunt and fish with my dad and my uncle. My uncle takes me on down to Flat, South Dakota, and we go on the Missouri River and we fish a lot down there. And then my dad has some land in down in Brookings or around there, down in that area. And we hunt and fish a lot down there as well.
And preparing for college means more than golf.
I'm going to be the president of Cancer Awareness Club this year, or my co-president, I guess. Co-president of Cancer Awareness Club. I'm in the environmental club. Cancer Awareness is where we like get money for different families. You create like baskets and stuff like that, and we just like kind of there for like people or families who have cancer. And then we have a T-shirt. And then this year we've been trying to get more and more members in the group so we can have more people volunteer to make blankets for people and just do different things to help out the community.
Off the course, Max is a great person. I know he's involved in extracurricular activities that really put other people first. So he's very much a people first versus putting his own agenda ahead of others. And I think that's exactly the type of person that we want on the team.
In fact, it's seniors like Max that make coaches like Rachel wonder about the future.
I think it's just important that, you know, you have a group of seniors come through, Max being one of them, that's really great, and you worry where your program's going to go from here. And we've got so many great young golfers that are learning from Max and our other seniors on how to be a leader, that I feel like our program is going to be in good shape for a long time.
Perhaps it's the essence of leadership that the most important traits Max sees in his coach, she sees in him.
She's done a really good job, like kind of bringing us all together as a team to make us have like more positive attitude towards the golf. And like, because when we're frustrated out in the course, it's nice to have someone there to calm me down a little bit and just kind of be there for you.
And as a leader, he has a good attitude about his final year of high school too.
We're a really hardworking group of kids that loves golf, and just we need to keep working at it, because I think when you put Roosevelt on the board again, golf hasn't really had a we got like dead last in the state tournament a couple years ago or something like that. And I think we need to put Roosevelt Golf back on the board. Just enjoying it, because this is my last year in high school, so just take it all in, because college is a whole different thing. Just kind of be in the moment, so that's what I want to do.
High school golf is so much fun to be a part of. The boys really support each other. It's not just when we're on the course, they're actually friends, you know, during the summer and the off season. So it's really fun to see them bond and then watch them support each other as they play their rounds.
There are more opportunities to learn about and watch Roosevelt's team. Check out the Sioux Falls School District's website. Click Schools, then Roosevelt, and select the calendar to learn more.